everybody, it's me, Steve Schneid, the CD Junkie, and thanks for tuning in to another episode of My 80s Memories. On this episode of My 80s Memories, I'm going to talk about the 1982 debut album by Strange Advance. And, you know, it is kind of cheating a little bit. This album is not really officially available on CD, but, you know, with a click of the mouse and a printer and a CDR burner, you can create your own Strange Advance Worlds Away on CD. Now, most of these tracks are currently available on CD. There's only a few that are missing. So if you find a Strange Advance compilation out there on CD, definitely check it out. If you find Strange Advance on vinyl, check it out. Definitely. So anyway, my memories of this album, look, in 1982, I was 18, 19, and I was record shopping all the time. A couple years before, I broke up with my first girlfriend, and I at that point in 82, I still wasn't trusting the female gender. So I found solace in music, and I found friendship in music. You know, when all my friends were going on dates, or they were going to parties or football games or whatever, I was at home listening to music. And that was by choice. I could have gone out, but I just chose, you know what? I trust music. It's not going to let me down. So one day when I'm out music shopping, I stumble across the album Worlds Away by Strange Advance. Now, I had not heard a single note of this album, but I looked at it, turned around, looked at the back, and I said, you know what? I'm going to buy this. I need this. It just spoke to me. I mean, it said, hey, Steve, buy me. You will not be disappointed. And guess what? I was not disappointed at all. I fell in love with this album on first listen. See, I'm an emotional listener. If an album doesn't move me within one, two, or three listens, I just go on to the next thing. But this thing hit me like a ton of bricks that first listen, and I fell in love with it. There was many layers. I mean, they're a synth pop band. So if you enjoy mid-year era Ultravox, John Fox solo, you might really, really dig this. In fact, if you love synth pop, or there's even a touch of progressive rock, there's a lot of pop rock elements on this album, and it's really an absolute joy to listen to. I remember hearing it with my headphones on and just being hit by, you know, She Controls Me and Love Games and, you know, Automatic Size and Sister Radio, and just going, oh my God, this is amazing. You know, Kiss in the Dark, Hold On to the Night, all these songs were just great, just really hook-filled. But there was a depth to them that allowed you to sort of, immerse yourself in the album and just feel these waves of melody sweep over you. It was just absolutely amazing. I remember turning a lot of my friends onto the album, you know, Jeff and Jeanette, maybe Debbie, all these people that I used to hang out with that were into synth pop and things like this, Ice House and bands like that, and then turning them onto this, and then they were turning their friends onto it, and it was turning into this real grassroots thing, but it was unfortunately Garden Grove, California grassroots, so it didn't send the album to the top of the charts, but it sent it to the top of the charts in our hearts. It's still a wonderful album. Just listening to it the other day, I mean, I've heard the songs on compilations, and they just fill me with so many great memories. I attach memories to everything I listen to, and so many memories attached to this album. But then when I heard it in its original order, it just brought back those memories. It just pieced everything together again. It was absolutely amazing. Now, here we are 40 years later. If you hear this album for the first time today, you might think like, oh, this is kind of dated. But, you know, that's the thing. It's like, you know, I've been listening to this album for 40 years. This was what technology was like back then. This was, you know, real songwriting, real vocals, cool arrangements, inventive, and just really a stunning album. And in fact, what I'm going to do is just after I'm done talking here, I'm going to put together just a really short medley of a few songs off the album so you can get an idea of what it sounds like. It's really, really wonderful. Back in 82, I'm sharing it with friends and people I worked with, and just trying to turn so many people onto it. And 39, 40 years later, I'm still doing it. Now, the band at this time was a trio. It was Drew Arnott on keyboards and vocals, Daryl Crom on vocals and guitar, and Paul Iverson on bass. Now, Paul Iverson would leave shortly after this album was released, and Drew and Daryl carried on for a few more albums, which are also great. But this album, this is the one that really, really stuck with me. It's just a wonderful treat still to listen to this day. About 2 years ago, I had the pleasure of interviewing Drew Arnott, who is the keyboard player and still a member of the band to this day. And it was such an amazing treat to talk to him for my Beach Blanket Fort Bingo audio podcast. And I'm hoping that maybe with the release of the forthcoming Strange Advance album, which will be their fourth, I'm hoping that maybe I can get him to participate in the Beach Blanket Fort Bingo video podcast, which you can watch episodes on this very channel right here on YouTube. My most recent interview is with another Canadian band called Spoons, and you should definitely check that out. Anyway, here comes some music by Strange Advance. That's it. Remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, and to ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me, I'm Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie.